So, good morning students. Good morning. Now, let us study some mathematics. Class second, mathematics we can do. You did a lot here in this season with the help of your teacher. Last year's first standard mathematics classes, all syllabus you revised in your first chapter. First chapter you revised a lot in mathematics. What is counting numbers, what is missing numbers, what is number names, what is number numerals, collection of figure for a particular number, that is numeral that you are knowing, and what comes before, what comes after, what comes between, and smallest number, greatest number, ascending order, descending order, expanded form, short form, addition, subtraction, word problems, such as a lot, many topics you covered here in your first chapter with the help of your teacher. Now it is the turn of second chapter, that is ordinal numbers. Are you ready? Sure, good. Let us study ordinal numbers. Before that, we have to study two type of numbers, two number systems here in this chapter. First is ordinal number system, the next is cardinal number system. Two numbers we are going to study in this chapter. Cardinal numbers. See, here in your textbook, your first portion, that is cardinal numbers. What is meant by cardinal numbers? For that purpose, one example is given over here. I shall zoom in for you. Now see this 8 balls in front of you. 8 balls. It's very clear, I think, in front of you. 8 balls are there. 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th. Like 8 balls are over here. If I will ask to you how many balls are there, then you should count over here and say 8. So, for the counting purpose, we are using certain numbers. Are you right? So, that numbers are called cardinal numbers. Once more, the numbers 1, 2, 3, which tells us the number of objects, number of items, number of things. Such type of numbers are called cardinal numbers. The numbers 1, 2, 3, which tells us the number of objects, number of items, are called cardinal numbers. If I will ask to you how many boys are there in your class, your answer will be 28. I am damn sure, because 28 students are sitting in front of me. And if I will ask to you how many girls are there, of course your answer is 12. Tall girls are here in our class. If I will ask how many students are there in your class, 40 will be your correct answer. So for the counting purpose, to tell the number of students, number of objects, number of items, number of people, number of bikes, number of bicycles, such type of things, idea, that numbers idea, that object strength, if you want to give, that can be given by the use of cardinal numbers. See, one school's picture is here in front of the school. A lot, many students are standing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 students are standing in front of you. That 6 is a cardinal number. Now, in these 6 students, everybody is in a line. See that Zardarji is laughing at what position? Can you say? That you can say by the use of next number system, that is called ordinal number system. If I want to say the position of the student, that can be easily expressed by the use of ordinal number. See, so first one is Ravi. He is in front of the queue. So he is the first fellow. Ravi is the first boy in the queue. And just behind Revi, we are seeing Samuel. Samuel, he is standing just behind Revi. So obviously, he is the second fellow. Then Rajat. Rajat is next to Revi. Yeah, next to Samuel. That is why Samuel is at third place. Then Baljeet, Sardarji, he is at the fourth place. And Irfan, he is at the fifth place. And at last, Vikas, he is at the sixth place. That first, second, third, fourth, fifth, these type numbers are called ordinal numbers. This type of numbers are called ordinal numbers. So you got an idea regarding the ordinal numbers, I think. See, so ordinal numbers are the numbers. Ordinal numbers are the numbers. Such as first, second, third, which tells us the position of an object in the collection are called ordinal numbers. The numbers such as first, second, third, which tell us the position of an object in the collection, that is called ordinal numbers. Are you clear? If you want to say at which place you are, if I will ask to you, who is the first rank holder in your class? Who is the rank holder? What is your rank? If I will ask to you, what will be your reply? Sir, 1. Sir, 2. Sir, I'm 3. Sir, I'm 4. That will not be a good answer. How will you give? You have to give your position by the use of ordinal numbers. Sir, I am the first in the class. I am the second in the class. Sir, I am the seventh rank holder in the class. Sir, she is the fifth rank holder in the class. In that way only you have to express the position. So such numbers are called ordinal numbers. Then our next topic, how we can represent these ordinal numbers. If it is a cardinal number, we are representing by the use of the numerals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. By the use of that figure, we will express the number. If it is 21, 2 and 1 are the digits and the collection of that figure, that 21 is the numeral form. In the same way, here also ordinal numbers we can represent by the use of first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, like so on, it will go on. These are the word format. Then if you want to express in a symbol short form, well, how you will write the cardinal number first, 1, then suffix st, 1 st, first, 2 nd, second, 3 RD, third, 4 TH, fourth. Then every number is same. Fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th, 19th, 20th. So like that the numbers will improve. Clear? So only if the number is ending with 1, that number and ST will be the suffix. If the number is ending with 2, the number and nd suffix. The number is ending with 3, that number and rd as the suffix. Or 4, 5, 6, all other numbers which is ending with 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then 0, then we can put th as the suffix. The only one exception is this one, 11th, 12th and 13th. 11, it is ending with 1, still we have to say it is 11th. 12th, a number is ending with 2, still we have to put th. 13th, ending with 3, still you have to keep th as the suffix. Clear? Rest of the all case, we have a common rule, that is st, nd, rd and th. Do you have any doubt? No. Then now we are going ahead. Some blanks are here in this table. You have to fill it up. 13th, 14th, 15th, like that. All numbers you have to write 12 to 20. Then 21st, 22nd, 23rd, like that. Up to 50th, you have to finish so that the things should be very clear in front of you. Now it is the turn of English alphabets. A to Z alphabets are written over here. If I will ask to you, T is at which position? So sure, you can say that T is at 20th letter in ABCD. ABCD is an alphabetical alphabet. It is having a particular order. In that order, T, its position is 20th. So T is the 20th letter. Which one is the 5th letter in ABCD? 5th letter, that is E. It's very clear. Just to go through this table and understand at what position the letters are belonging. Clear? Now we will go ahead the next topic. Oh, it is the exercise topic. So here 16 animals are in a queue. By seeing the 16 animal, you have to fill the blanks. Cow, 1, 2, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. Cow is at the 8th place. The dash is the 15th place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15th place. This is the 15th place. So 15th place, what is there? Fish. So we will say the fish is at the 15th place. Will you fill these blanks? Yes, of course you can do. Because you studied from me, no? Then next one is fill the blanks. Fill the blanks with the correct position of the alphabet. K is the dash letter in the word cricket. Cricket, C-R-I-C-K-E-T. C-R-I-C-K. K is at 5th place. So you have to write this is the 5th letter in the word. Like elephant, A. A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6th letter. A is at the 6th place. So you can write 6th letter in the word. Like that you can fill it up. The vowel in bungalow, B-U-N-G-A-L-O-W, B-U, second is U, U-A-E-I-O-U are the vowels. Here three vowels we can say, one is U, other is A, other one is O. U is at second place and A is at fifth place I think and O is at seventh place I think. Just count it and verify the matter, then write second, fifth and seventh places. Then now the next case is Tuesday. Tuesday is which day? If the Monday is the first day, Tuesday will be second day. And Thursday will be fourth day. Then Sunday will be seventh day. Just to see the order. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So count and say the position. Month also, January, February, March, April, May. January, February, March, April, May. May is at the 5th place. So 5th month of the year is May. Then August or November you can find. Then see the pattern. The 5th figure. What is the 5th figure? 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th is a triangle. It is not a normal triangle. It is a blue triangle. So 5th place you have to write it is a blue triangle. Then 12th place you will write say it is a red circle. Because 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. So it is of 12th place, it is a red circle. So here we are binding this chapter, I think. Yes, of course. So go through the exercise, fill the exercise and write down there at your copy and study well and utilize this lockdown time for more and more studies and take care about your health also. Stay safe. Keep distancing from others and take care. Thank you.